The COMELEC will open at least 145 ballot boxes recalled from precincts that showed discrepancies between the random manual audit and the PICOS tally. The random manual audit committee will determine whether these so-called variances were caused by technical glitches or by human error, and whether they are statistically significant to affect the poll results.
Now, while the discrepancies have caused concern among voters and poll watchdogs, the COMELEC insists there's no need to worry about the initial results of the manual count, since data are not yet complete. The poll body is set to release the complete results of the RMA on June 13th, or exactly a month after the midterm elections.
And for our discussion, we're joined here in the studio by Parish Pastoral Council for Responsible Voting Chairperson, Tita De Villa. She's also the head of the Commission on Elections Random Manual or RMA Audit Committee.
Send us your comments and questions through Twitter using the hashtag PrimeTime or post them on our Facebook page. It's ANC247. Ambassador, good evening to you and thanks for joining us tonight.
Well, thank you very much, Madam Ambassador, for joining
you.
Us here.
You are flying. I came from the office in UN Avenue.
Thank you for defying gravity and the traffic to reach
That's
us
great.
In the studio. Well, so far, 145 ballot boxes opened that have showed discrepancies. We're supposed to count from how many legislative districts?
234.
Yeah.
Let me clarify a bit. Out of these 234 clustered precincts from the legislative districts, we have already received 205 reports from the random manual audit team, the teachers who counted the ballots in those places. And out of these 205 reports, we are recalling or retrieving 155 ballot boxes that we feel we should open because of the variances that we saw in the reports. Of the 155 ballot boxes, 30 ballot boxes have been opened and counted because we couldn't clear the variances just by the validators who are looking at them for any possible errors. So of the 13 open ballot boxes, I would say 99.99% have been cleared of variances.
Have been cleared
yes,
of variances.
Of variances. Okay. From checking the ballots against the accountable forms or the sheets submitted by the random manual audit team. Mm-hmm. Because many really did show that there was some clerical error or else in transposing the numbers to words, some errors have been committed, and also human appreciation, I would say. Those are the three things we look for, the human factor, possible reasons of the variances. So out of the 30 ballot boxes that we have opened and one by one inspected the ballots compared to the report of the random manual audit team, as I said, 99.99% have been cleared. But this is not finished yet, no? Because we
Certainly.
Have to go through 2,205 minus 234, about 29 reports yet that we have to receive. And out of the 155 ballot boxes, 30, that would be 125
right.
that we have to go through still.
Now, remember when we were talking about how a random manual audit was also done before,
yes.
and when the variances came out, they were attributed to the conditions under which the auditors were conducting their job, first of all, if they had begun it in the afternoon and they worked all the way until early the next morning without food or water in a hot and humid room. Are these factors still being considered now?
The same, the same. Because as I said, some of the polling places where they conducted this, they don't even have a table as big as this, very small. And you know the tally sheets are very big.
Mm-hmm.
So under those conditions, and aside from the fact that many of them were able to open the ballot boxes again for the RMA, about past midnight.
Right.
So as you said, hungry, tired, sleepy. Those factors, of course, have an effect on the count being done.
All right, but we still can't see, of course, the overall picture with having just 50 ballot boxes open. Right. But as you say, 99.99% cleared.
Of the 30 that were open.
Of the 30 that were open. What would be a substantial variance, if there were any, to actually say that there was something irregular in how the PICOS machine counted the votes?
If, for example, after opening the ballot boxes, the validators, we would see still variances of 10 and above, we give this already to the NSO to encode, and they will be the ones to determine statistically what percentage
should be acceptable. So 10 mistakenly counted votes?
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
Per ballot?
10 difference from the manual count to the electronic count.
Are we talking here per ballot? Or for the overall
per report, yes,
okay.
per clustered polling precinct.
I see.
Given that, as you said, 99.99% of the 15 of the 30 boxes are now cleared of variances. Does this give you some sort of does this boost now your confidence?
Oh, yes, of course.
Because in the beginning you were like, you know, we have to be very, very concerned about this particular
because
situation.
Because we're very careful, really. If they only see the work of the validators, it's not easy to be looking for one by one. The one report that I saw. Without opening the ballot box, I always say that, you know, the taras-taras, they have four diagonal lines and four vertical lines
and then
one diagonal that's counted for five.
Right.
Three of the groups of five had only four, because after three, they put the one diagonal line. So you should count it only as four.
But
when they tallied, they counted it as five because of that diagonal line.
But then when you went back and when you opened...
Yes, one by one, we looked at it, not even opening the ballot box yet. Because we try as much as possible to clear the variances on site by the validators before we resort to opening the ballot box.
So iisa-isahin niyo muna yon.
Iisa-isa, sinusuyo.
So yung particular form na yon, nung inisa-isa niyo po, okay naman yung kinalabasan or talagang kinailangan niyo nga buksan yung...
May mga iba na clear of some of the variances by just on-site validation na iniisa-isa. Yung mga hindi na talaga ma-clear, kahit na ilang pang validators ang tumingin, binubuksan na yung ballot box to count again the ballots inside.
Now, this really underscores the importance of RMAs.
Yes, yes. And also the work that goes into it, so that we cannot just say out of opening 30 ballot boxes out of the 155 that we have to open, that they have been cleared at least of 99.99. I cannot say that that's the final thing, no? That I cannot even say, if I will be very truthful about it, is that not yet. We cannot even say, ooh, good. Because this is only 30 ballot boxes.
Because I was going to ask you, because the COMELEC chief has insisted in a previous interview, I think, that there's no need to worry about the initial results of the RMA, because the data that has come out are not yet complete.
Yes. Well, I could say he has, some of that is true, because we are not yet even one-third through the validation.
So conversely, you're saying even if 15 of the 30
of the 155
have been cleared, it shouldn't be any cause for celebration
to celebrate or not to be unduly worried.
Do you think, though, that you will be done and you will be able to meet that deadline? And
he mentioned, I think, a deadline of June 13th.
Yes.
1 month after.
Right.
We're trying our best, but I would say a conservative estimate would be June 22. Because, 1 week later, because I don't want to rush the validators, the Random Manual Audit Committee. We don't want to pressure too much the validators because they might make more mistakes,
Tony.
But we will try. Tony, at this point, I'd like to make clear, the Random Manual Audit is being conducted by the COMELEC.
Yes.
It just so happens that I'm
the chairperson.
Chair of the Random Manual Audit Committee, who happens to be chair of PPCRB.
Okay. All right. Well, we of course need to know how the Random Manual Audit will turn out in its entirety before we can say this can make the difference between people trusting the PICOS machine or not.
Yes, yes. So that's why we are very, very careful about reports that we give out, and we always say that this is still in process. So there is not to make a big deal out of piecemeal reports that are given out. No?
I need to ask you, Ambassador, because we remember, of course, from the 2010 vice presidential contest that then Liberal Party candidate Mar Rojas had contested the election victory of Vice President Jejomar Binay. So there is an ongoing electoral protest going on, which involves a recount of certain disputed ballots or areas.
If I can remember correctly, all of the ballot boxes of the entire elections were recalled to be involved in the
walang specific areas. Because what was at the heart of that protest was the supposed null votes that Mar Rojas, that Secretary Rojas, had contested, which he said could have been counted to him.
Would have made a difference.
Right.
Yes.
Now, with that ongoing, is there any, can you say, connection now, or you see impact now that this RMA may have on that election protest?
Of the 2010, the difference, the variance that still remained when we made a report, the NSO ruled it as statistically improbable to have affected any position
in 2010.
In 2010, yes.
Statistically.
It was not big enough to affect any of the results, whether national or local.
So in essence, the electoral protest or the recount that Secretary Rojas is having his lawyers do,
I wouldn't say that because this only involved 1,000 plus precincts, clustered precincts, whereas I think the protest involves the entire country, the entire 76,347 clustered precincts. I can't say that that rules out.
All right. We do want to thank our guest, Ambassador Henrietta De Villa of PPCRB, for coming over and talking to us. Our apologies, Ambassador. We had to cut our discussion short.
I'm so worried too because my grandson lives in the Surrendra.
Well, I hope you get
happily not in Surrendra too.
But he's okay now because he's in a meeting.
I called him. Yes, he's outside.
All right. Well, good to hear that, Madam Ambassador. Thank you very much again.
Thank you too. Thank you.
Thank you.